It's the middle of a school day, but high school senior Stephen Batch is not in a classroom. He's hard at work at ProMedica Bixby Hospital.
Me and Lance just did the light bulbs, and we did fix a lot of things like toilets.
Lance Patrick is Stephen's mentor through Project Search, a collaborative program that teaches students with developmental disabilities life and job skills they would not learn in a traditional classroom.
And our students participate in 3 12-week internships in 8 different departments. And we provide job coaching and instruction within our classroom. And each internship is, our intern is matched with a mentor who teaches them the everyday goings-on of what they go through in each department.
It's a big commitment from mentors like Lance, who still have to fulfill their own work responsibilities while taking time to train a student with special needs.
At first, it was kind of, I worked with him from like 9 to 2, so I tried to get all my work done between 7 and 9 and 2 to 3:30. You know, so I could slow down and work with him. But by the end of the time, it was just like working with one of the rest of the other guys.
The students don't have direct patient contact, but the work they do does impact patient care because they are able to perform routine, time-consuming tasks that caregivers would otherwise spend time doing. But program facilitator Amanda Brooks says the students in Project Search accomplish something even bigger.
Our patients are seeing these students, our community members that are here visiting their families are seeing this, and they see that someone with a developmental disability can do the same job that another employee without that can do. And I think that is really key. Not only are we maybe helping to inform our staff about what those with disabilities have to offer, but also the community. And the more people are here, the more the word spreads, it's just going to be better for our county and our community.
The goal of Project Search is to make these students employable so they can get jobs and live independently. In addition to their work rotations, the students spend time in a classroom at the hospital, learning social skills like communication and eye contact, and life skills like how to open and maintain a bank account. All 6 students who completed the pilot program have secured jobs. Colton Lagore is just one of the success stories. He earned a job at ProMedica Provincial House, an assisted living facility in Adrian.
I was very happy that I got the job. I think it's good to help people, and I've cleaned the floors, waxed it, and I have done the dining room, and the people here, they are fun.
Colton just got his first paycheck and his own apartment, a goal Stephen has also set for himself.
Because I just want to live by my own. I'm a grown man.
It's become quite evident that he's ready to go. He'll talk to people, he'll make eye contact. We'll talk about making small talk, and he's doing that now. He's just a new young man, and a confident young man, ready to really jump into adulthood.
In fact, the very day we shot this story, Stephen learned he had nailed the interview and got a job offer at Borchard Brothers Market near his home in Blissfield.
When a student comes in and says, I've got a job and I start next week and here's what I'm going to be making and here's my hours and this is what I'm going to do with my first paycheck, that's great for our staff to be able to say, you know, I played a part in that. I made a difference in someone's life today.
Through the teamwork of Project Search and ProMedica Bixby Hospital, these students have learned skills to live independently, but they've also taught a lesson to others about living with dignity.
I'd like to see him keep his job and get his own apartment and a car like he wants to, and can cruise up to the ice cream place.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.